Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
All right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, all week we've been talking about Lisa's question of how to format every other row. Remember on Monday, we talked about how to use the format autoformat, Alt-O-A, and applied two rows of green, two rows of white. On Tuesday, Lisa's trick of using the fill handle where we could use any two colors that we wanted. And then on Wednesday, conditional formatting basically chose the one color for the odd numbered rows. On Thursday, we had the 54 formats in the table times 20 different colors, so a whole bunch of different options there. But what if we want to use that table functionality, but we want to replicate what we had back on Monday, two rows of green and two rows of white, or something like that? The table functionality actually has those 54 built-in formats, but many more formats are possible. I'll show you how to do it. I'm going to use my shortcut key of Ctrl T to turn on the table. Click OK. That's because I'm going to go in and create my own table style. So all the way at the bottom of this gallery is something called New Table Style. I'm going to format this. I want to go to the first row stripe and say that that first row is two rows tall. Choose format and I'll choose a color. Let me go with this green here. Click OK. And then I'll go to second row stripe and say that that is two rows tall. I'll choose format and let me choose something else, maybe this light yellow here. Click OK. All right, you can see the preview now. We're doing green, yellow, green, yellow. If I wanted this to be the format that I got everywhere in this document, I could set this as the default table style. That would be what I would get for Control T. Matter of fact, let's go ahead and do that. Click OK. All right. Now, setting up that style doesn't change the table that I'm in because I've already declared that table. But if I come back to the gallery, I now have the custom. And I can choose custom, and very quickly we've assigned alternating rows of green and yellow. So as you can imagine here, you can set up the first row stripe however you'd like, one row, two rows, three rows, four rows, up to eight, I think, and the second row stripe however you'd like. So you actually have absolute control here over how we do that formatting. We're not stuck with the 54 formats that they built in for us. Great feature that allows us to very quickly go through and format the table. Now, let me tell you, this table functionality, there's a couple of weird things with it. We get the auto filter drop downs at the top. They're now called filter. They turn off a couple of things that might be important to you. Custom views goes away once you use the table functionality. So, if you find the table functionality just annoying the heck out of you because it turns off something that you want, then I have a strategy. Go in here and use the formatting and then come back to Table Tools Design and say convert to range. When you convert to a range, it turns off all the cool table tools, but it leaves behind the formatting. Now, the formatting is no longer interactive. If I insert a row, it's still going to act just like it did on Monday and Tuesday. But still, this might be a very fast way to apply some formatting and then get rid of the table functionality in case some of those features are causing problems for you. All right. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.